Okay, welcome back to Liquid Audio in Perth, Western Australia. Liquid Audio, Church and Classic Audio. And don't let it ever be said that I only work on direct drive decks. Not true. I do work on belt drive decks as well, and especially if it's an existing customer of mine that owns one. And that's what happened with this lovely old Linn Sondek LP12. This is one of the classic, almost original ones. It's a very, very old one from the early 70s, early to mid 70s. Came fitted with a 3009, an SME 3009 arm, and let's just say this deck hadn't run for about 20 years. All right, now it needed, I didn't film this at the beginning, I'm only filming it now as I'm just playing a test record, but let's just say that everything had to be overhauled, repaired, cleaned, adjusted, and lubed. She's got brand new Linn bearing oil, the black oil, a brand new Linn belt. I've lubricated the motor, cleaned and tidied up all the platter and subplatter. I've had the whole arm out. It's all been cleaned. Everything's been meticulously adjusted. The one thing the owner doesn't have is his anti-skate thread with weight, but I'll find one of those for him and I'll order that in and fit that when that arrives. I've set up the arm, adjusted all the lateral balance, the tracking force, the azimuth, of course, and we fitted a nice new Autophon 2M bronze because his Fidelity Research FR1 was clapped out. Not only that, it shouldn't have been fitted to this arm. Anyone that knows a little bit about this will know that the FR1 doesn't really balance up properly on this arm. It's too heavy. We would have needed to add extra weight at the rear end. And mechanically, it's probably not ideal for this arm anyway in terms of its compliance. So, plus it was dead. So we took the opportunity to fit a mechanically well-matched cartridge and it's running very well. Of course, I've had to re-level all the suspension. I don't know if you can see this, but you know, it's about as level as I can get it, you know, in terms of that the arm board is level. And what I always try and go for with these LP12s is to get the, you know, the gap between the platter and the chassis roughly the same all the way around, which when you're dealing with three big wobbly springs, isn't actually that easy. I mean, I measure it, of course, with a precision rule and that's how we do that. But yeah, look, this is actually working really well. I'm extremely happy. Now, of course, servicing LP12s isn't cheap. The belts are very expensive. The oil is somewhat expensive. But you've got to remember that as we're looking at it now, a basic LP12 with a decent arm is over $4,000, probably $5,000 or $6,000 Australian. You know, so this, in the context of what we've done here with a new cartridge and a complete overhaul, is actually a really good deal for my customer, and I'm sure he's going to be very happy. I've done a lot of other work for this guy, including servicing and overhauling all of his Accuphase gear. Now, of course, I've done my usual things. I don't know if you can see. Obviously, you would have needed to see this before, but I've oiled all of the wood. It just looks a million bucks compared to how it was. It still has a few little scuffs and bumps, as you can see, but it's got a lovely luster to it now. I hope that comes through in the video. And look, I've got to say, this deck is just working really well, which is what you want. It's just playing a record nicely as it should, and yeah, it's come up really well. I'm very, very happy with this, and I'm sure her owner will be too. So hey, look, I don't normally work on Linns. A good friend of mine is the Linn agent and specialist, and look, if you're an existing customer of mine, yes, I'm happy to work on your LP12 for you. I find them quite interesting to work on. And if you'd like some, if you'd like to, you know, have a chat about that, feel free to get in contact with me, Mike at Liquid Audio in Perth, Western Australia. Otherwise, if you already deal with the official Linn service agent, then feel free to keep visiting him. He's a, as I say, a very good friend of mine and does a superb job also. So yeah, that's a Linn LP12, a bit different from my usual Japanese decks and Thorins and things that I look at, but why not? It's all vinyl. Thanks for watching.